Let's talk prepping the nail with a sanding band. So this nail has gel polish on it, the base, and you can see a little bit of that green color along the edges that I didn't take off quite yet, that I left to use with a softer bit, the sanding band, when I remove the color. So sanding bands definitely still have their place in my book. There's a couple rules I follow with them and a couple reasons I reach for them. So number one, you can see, like, see how you see the band spinning and it looks like it's going really slow? It's going really slow. This is meant to like almost replace a hand file, right? Guys, it's at like 5 or 6 thousand RPMs. That's it. So if your e-file bogs down that slow, you need to get your e-file serviced, or you need to get a more professional grade e-file. So you should be able to run something this slow so that you're being safe on the nail. Otherwise, it's out of paper, so it will trap too much heat. I like the little bit of give the sanding band has, and I love how I can use it to shape a little bit over the base. And like there, I barely tapped that dry callus on the edge and it just exfoliates it off. And it's not hurting her because it's going slow. If you run this fast, you'll create way too much friction. You'll go right through the nail plate. You'll hurt your client's living tissue. You don't want to do any of that. It just is helping you scratch the new growth up to give a tiny bit of texture. And then right here, I'm gonna take it and work on the transition from the new growth to the existing product. Now you can do the same light-handed work on the natural nail to prep it before any application. But key points, run it so slow. Like, you should be able to put your finger on it and it doesn't feel hot. That is important, which means you need a really good e-file and you need to make sure it's serviced. The other thing is super light touch. I am not doing a lot of pressure here or I would injure my client. I know I don't show these a ton, so I want to show these options because I love it when I am shaping my new soft gel polish base that's on there still, because it's such a softer product and it just feels nice. So don't throw your sanding bands away, but do not use them fast. And make sure you're using, like, I would never go more aggressive than a medium grit, especially if I'm gonna touch the natural nail. So you can see there, it's ready for some cuticle work, but it's got a nice smooth transition from new growth to existing base, and we're all ready to go to cuticles.